Hi, my name is Vesna Karapetrova, and we're here today at Canadian Macedonian Place on August 26th. It's Tuesday, and the year is 2014. And we're here to interview Mr. Dusan Neceski. Welcome, Mr. Neceski, to our interview here, and thank you so much for sharing your life story with us for the archives of the Canadian Macedonian Historical Society.
Okay.
Can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay, thank you very much. Ja sam Dusan Neceski, inače poznana je Opinčar ili Čevlar, da mnogo odavna sam počinom za najeto I inače sam od sela Vasherejca.
Ali... So you actually your profession is making shoes for ethnic dancers, right?
Dancer.
Yes.
Dancing shoes for
different ethnic groups.
Po naše rečeno opinci, a inače dancing shoes ovde kao Kanada I to nekoliko nacionalnosti dancing shoes.
Yes, that's a good point. For which kind of nationalities do you usually make your shoes?
First, rekao deka da se iz Macedonije.
Macedonian, good.
Under Serbian, Ukrainian, Polski.
Polish. Croatian.
Croatian, mm-hmm. Very good. Croatian. And first, Opinok I did in Kitchener, Waterloo, because there I was living first
yes.
time. And then that time, first opinok that Croatian, because people, Croatian people, they bring me sample what kind shoes you needed.
Yes.
That time I know Croatian. Croatian, they have six, seven different style. And they and bring me that they call Šestinski. After I know that Šestinski, because Croatian, I live 1955 in Zadar. Zadar.
You Hrvatska. Lived in Croatia,
Croatian,
in Zadar?
Zadar. And I doing Croatian shoes in the all of them moccasin, we call moccasin. That time I going to Zadar, Šibenik, Dubrovnik. That's my area where I going for people buy. That time from to Yugoslavia.
It used to be Yugoslavia at that time. That's right.
And you know, this is very, very good bazar, you know, mm-hmm. how they call
Mm-hmm. Good. We'll talk about your first beginnings in your occupation.
Yeah.
Can you tell us again what village you come from?
I come from Prilep.
The town is Prilep, yes?
Prilep.
And where were you born?
I go to Zadar.
You Zadar, were born in Zadar?
Uh-huh. Oh, no, born in Vasherejca.
Vasherejca.
That is Bitolski kruk.
Area, in Bitola area.
Yeah,
in
1932. Come to Prilep.
Yes.
1937.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And after going starting school.
Yes.
In the first 1940, because that time coming in Bulgarian, in Macedonian.
Yes.
Bulgarian, you know.
The army.
People, army. Mm-hmm. And we learning Bulgarski.
Bulgarian.
Bulgaria.
Yes. So when you were born in Vasherejca,
yeah.
Did you have brothers and sisters?
Yes, I have.
Can you tell us who they are?
I don't know which is born in Vasherejca, which is born in Prilep, because I nas eight kids.
You have a big family.
Big
eight
family.
Kids.
Eight kids.
Okay, eight siblings.
Yeah, and when coming there in Prilep, Prilep living a long time, and then today I have brother and sister.
Sisters in Prilep.
Yes.
Why did you move to Prilep from Vasherejca?
Oh, because everybody, they no have job to do.
No jobs.
And no jobs. But coming to Prilep, one brother going to Kovac.
He was a blacksmith.
Still. And another time, the tailor. Another, I going to, for shoes, opanki, opanzi.
The shoemaker for the opanzi, yes.
Yeah. And one after going to chauffeur for driving.
Or driving a truck.
Truck, like that.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody we have that time, and father, he tell me that time, don't pay for not spend money for another people. Spend money on your brother. Mm-hmm. Or they keep buy some stuff from you, like that,
mm-hmm.
you know. They think like that, or not exactly, because that's is changing.
That, yes.
You know, very,
right.
very, in Yugoslavia, it's very nice, it's changing.
Uh-huh. And who was your father and mother, their names?
Name, my father is Petko, my mother Jovanka.
And were they both from Vasherejca?
No, born father born in Vasherejca, a mother born in Prilepec, not Prilep, Prilepec.
Mm-hmm.
My father, he died first wife, and
his first wife died. Yes, died,
he married from mother here. What they have about 5-6 kids from this mother, exactly brother and mother, you know,
mm-hmm.
or together.
So you have some brothers and sisters from the first mother, I mean, from the first wife.
I have before one sister, one brother,
mm-hmm.
for first mother.
Yes, from his first wife,
six, seven born mother and father for this mother.
That's your mother. So
yes.
your mother actually
yes, yes.
had
my
six,
mother,
seven children.
Yeah.
Yes. And what language did you speak when you were in Vasherejca?
Macedonian. That's Macedonian. All of them, the Macedonian.
Your father,
father,
your grandparents?
Everything, they Macedonian.
Uh-huh. And were your grandparents from Vasherejca as well?
Yeah. Yes, yes.
Your whole
all
family?
All family from there.
Do you remember your grandparents?
No.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Grandparents, no. I know that's brother or together. My father and brother, they live for together.
Yes.
After, you know, they changing.
Your father's
separate,
brother,
separate
so you know, the, knew him.
No.
And what language did they speak?
Then the Macedonian.
So everybody spoke Macedonian in Vasherejca.
Oh, yeah.
And when you went from Vasherejca to Prilep, how old were you?
That time, I think so, 5, 4, 32 born, 37 move to Prilep, mm-hmm. about 5 years. Like
so you
that.
Were only 5 years old?
Yes.
When you moved to Prilep?
To Prilep.
And you moved because your father wanted to give you
some kind of
occupation, so your whole family moved with all the children.
All children, you know, for mm-hmm. In Prilep, they big city,
mm-hmm.
they have so many zanait.
Trades, different trades, yes.
Trend. For like that, they coming here, you know, in Prilep, mm-hmm. like that. In that time, I starting very early, I go to school. And,
yes, when did you start school?
School for 1940.
1940.
Mm-hmm.
And this was in Prilep?
Yeah, in 1945 I starting go to shoes.
Oh, you started your shoe trade in 1945.
Yes.
So for 5 years you
yes.
went to school.
Yes.
Yes. What language did you speak in the school?
Macedonian. All in school, Bulgarian.
At that time, it was Bulgarian.
So, or you speak at home, Macedonian.
So from 1940 to 1945, all your schooling was in Bulgarian.
Bulgarian,
mm-hmm.
yes.
Did you have to speak Bulgarian?
Yeah, it's that time I speak. Or
mm-hmm.
now, Not very much, no.
Were your teachers from Bulgaria or were they from Prilep?
Born from Prilep.
So they were Macedonian?
Teacher born from Macedonia.
Uh-huh. But the books were all in...
That's important to speak in the school all Bulgarian.
Mm-hmm. In the schoolyard, when you had recess and you were playing with the other children, what language did you speak?
Macedonian.
Yeah. Was there a problem? Did the teachers mind?
No.
Everything was okay?
It's okay. So you could speak. Nobody. Just when go to school, supposed to be you know what you learning, you know.
Yes.
That's the first time we going to molitva, how they call
praying, yes.
That time, and I know many stikotvorbi they remember now.
Poems, yes. You were taught poems, yes.
80 years.
Oh.
I know. Asam bulgarsche prekrasno, asobicham.
You remember some of those poems that you were taught by the teachers?
Yeah.
Yes.
I don't know. I forgot so many from tomorrow,
yes.
From yesterday, I forgot. Mm-hmm. And now I remember that time what molitva. Деда Господи, прости ме, моля ти се от душа.
Да.
Суми разум надари ме да не мога да греша.
Чичко, Dusan.
Можело и по нашем.
Yes, but so when you went to school, you spoke Bulgarian because the language was the teachers were Bulgarian.
Da.
But when you went out of school, between the children, you spoke Macedonian.
Macedonian.
At home, you spoke
Macedonian.
Sure. Did you think that? What did you think about what you are? Did you think you're Macedonian or that you're Bulgarian?
No, Macedonian is my language because.
Yes.
I know everybody understand that Macedonian,
right.
Speak Macedonian.
Right.
No, in the street, going Bulgarian, no. No. That it,
you nobody. Didn't have to speak
if
Bulgarian on the
you
street.
You speak Bulgarian if you find something Bulgarian.
Official,
man,
like a school.
No, school or like that.
Or an office,
no, yeah,
then you have to speak
Bulgarian. Not everybody. They
but
speak,
everybody...
They speak Macedonian.
And they said that they're Macedonian or they're Bulgarian?
That Macedonian, everything for Macedonian, no.
And the people felt that they're
Macedonian. Sure.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Macedonian.
And you stayed in school for 5 years to learn to read and write.
That time, 4 years.
Four years.
And finish school.
And how old were you then?
4 years, about 13, 14 years, like that.
Yes.
13 years, 14.
And then tell us what happened, what kind of school you continued. You said you...
When finished school and going for...
trade.
Yeah.
Trades.
For shoes. For.
Yes. How did you pick the shoe business? Why did you pick to become a shoemaker?
I don't understand that.
Zašto go odbravte da pravite čevli?
Oh, because my father, he know that guy.
Yes.
Who
was a shoemaker.
Oh, no, shoemaker. And he tell me that, okay, going there. And every day I going there. I was before school, before finish school.
Yes.
I going, because that school going to 12 o'clock. Afternoon going in the business.
Yes.
And every day like that, you know, every day. Don't not changing in the morning or maybe next year we changing something like that.
So,
never changing.
So you went to school up to 12 o'clock and after 12 o'clock you started, you went to learn how to make the
yes,
shoes.
Yes.
Yes, and that was until you were about 13, 14?
Yeah.
You started when you were 13, 14.
I started in 1945.
Mm-hmm.
That time, 45, about 13, 14 years like that.
Yes.
I remember.
Right.
Very long, yeah. And after 3 years, my store or my
your
boss,
teacher, your teacher, yes.
For shoes, they talk to my father.
Mm-hmm.
They pay some money. I don't know how much.
Mm-hmm.
Or I know 3 years I don't take money from him. And father, my do not pay to him for teach me. or just a friendly like that. Mm-hmm. Every one time a year, give me one pair of shoes.
So for three years, how to, you were an apprentice,
yes,
and you learned how to make shoes. From the teacher, who,
yes,
was a master, yes?
Yes,
and he didn't pay you anything for three years.
Nothing paid.
And your father didn't have to pay.
Not just me, all of it, who.
Everybody.
Everybody who going in the
trades,
learning, doesn't marry a tailor or a shoemaker. Always 3 years, nothing to do, nothing. Doing something, I don't know, never going in the machine for sewing.
No.
No, do not teach to you for 3 years.
Really?
No.
So you didn't learn everything?
Learning everything, small.
Little by little.
Try this,
yes,
try this, like that, you know.
And then after now, 3 years, what happened?
I don't know how they call niggle, no niggle, they bruchina, kako se vika.
What are they?
Needles? Nils. I think so, nils.
Needles?
Nils. When pull up the shoes,
yes,
put to be put needles.
Oh.
Nils.
Nails. Yes.
Nils, yeah.
Yes.
Then I'm doing first nils.
Yes.
When go first time, that time, when first going there, full boxes for nails. For broken, like that.
The nails were broken.
Yeah, because when used, doesn't stay straight.
Oh.
What's to be I doing?
So you were straightening nails.
Nails.
They were
straight,
old nails. And your job was to straighten the nails.
So many bucks. Maybe I tell to you, 10 bucks, 15 bucks. Everybody, not just me. And same after me, coming another guy, boy.
Yes.
And they doing same thing. First time for hammer, for you know where you punch.
Yes.
You know, that's the learning.
Yeah, so it was a hard job to learn. First,
yes,
you had to,
yes,
to straighten the nails.
For hand, how that sometimes I know, and I have one in Kitchener when put coming for help me,
yeah,
in the wheelchair.
Yes,
and put the nails is gone.
Oh, so he didn't know how to,
No.
Yes.
No level in the hand, you know,
yes,
never doing, you know,
he
first
didn't
time
have experience,
same,
yes.
Same too.
All right.
Same too.
And then, and then what happened? You
after after doing with my boss, he have three people older who understand doing shoes.
Who knew how to make shoes?
Make shoes. And I helped to him.
You help him. So you got employed in the job.
Yes.
So then he paid you?
Yes, that time they pay.
After you finished the 3 years?
That, yeah.
So how long did you stay with him, work for him?
For him?
Yes.
Long time. Because depending when I learning everything,
yes,
doing myself,
yes,
and starting. I know... 1947, 48.
Yes.
I going to that time open in Prilep shoe factory.
Yes.
Shoe factory, I go there and me and my boss who doing or together.
Yes.
Because everyone, one chirak, one boss.
Yes.
And one pair shoes for pay today. For met money for me and for him.
Yes.
When come to Kanaga, I go to a grip shoes factory.
Yes.
10 people, 800 shoes.
They would make 800 shoes in the factory.
About 30, 40 for each, every work. That's much different. Or the here, all this not by hand.
That's right.
All that mm-hmm. machine.
Right.
Everything machine.
And how long did you stay in Prilep then?
Prilep stayed my life, 30 to 33 years.
And all the time you worked for the same shop?
Same shop. They moving when coming factory, they coming mm-hmm. moving to factory.
Yes.
After going to school, because going to factory, then after night going to school. I going to school for salesman.
Salesman. You were salesman. Going to school to be a salesman.
Salesman.
Yes.
After 3 years, that's going.
Yes.
And going 5 years to work for salesman.
Oh, so you worked as a salesman there.
Yes.
In Macedonia.
Macedonia.
Okay.
After that.
What did you sell?
Sell so many stuff. I was in Železaria or how they call.
Metal things, yeah. Yes.
And after going
tools. Chairs?
For
house sell. Furniture?
Furniture, yes.
Okay, that's
for furniture?
Yes.
That's about 3-4 years like that.
Yes.
Yes. And after that, going to school for high school, Visoko kvalifiko.
Yes, to become a master.
Yeah,
yes,
master.
For the
and
shoes.
Yes, no, for salesman.
For salesman, okay.
When you want salesman, or go to shoe for sell shoes.
Oh, you started to sell shoes.
Start to sell shoes.
Okay.
Sell shoes, you know. Mm-hmm. And that time I finished that and come to Canada.
Okay, why did you come to Canada?
I come to Canada because my brother is here.
Yes.
And I was one time in visit here, and I see that nice country, because how they call that economy is very important for people. They see when working just 8 hours or 10 hours mm-hmm. and sit down, relax or like that.
Yes.
And you have house, you have good job. Like that, and economy is the good.
So you liked what you saw in Canada, the economy.
Same in Yugoslavia. Before Yugoslavia, my father, 73 years old, he died. He never buy house there, because in the village,
yes,
they have house,
yes,
or nobody buy.
Yes,
and when come to Prilep,
yes,
they renting house.
All his life he had to rent, yes.
That's economy of the Tito. It's very nice. 32 years old, I made house that time.
So you made a house in Macedonia?
Macedonia.
Mm-hmm.
When they made house, and I go coming to Canada, because Canada, much better economy.
Yes.
Much better economy, I come to Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Now starting in Canada, 2 jobs.
So when you came to Canada, you came because your brother was here?
Yes.
And he sponsored you. Did you come by yourself?
No, family. First time I would visit myself.
Yes.
After I coming for family.
Then you brought your family?
Yes.
So your family was in Macedonia?
That time is Macedonia.
Yes, and who were, can you tell us about your wife and your children? Who is your wife? Kako se vika ženata?
Luba.
Yes, your wife is
my
Luba.
My wife, Luba,
uh-huh.
Yeah.
And your children?
Children, they have Maria,
mm-hmm.
Lydia, and Živce, my son.
Okay, yeah. And were they all in Macedonia?
From Macedonia. He was born in Macedonia.
But you came by yourself? Right. I know you came once as a visitor. You went back to Macedonia because
yes.
you liked what you saw in Canada.
Yes.
And then you decided to come with your whole family.
Yes.
Did you come with your whole family or just...
Whole family.
Everybody came together.
Come together.
Okay, and where did you come?
I come with Kitchener, Waterloo.
Your brother was in Kitchener?
It's Kitchener.
Okay, and when you came to Kitchener, what was how did you start your life,
Kitchener,
your business?
Yeah, Kitchener, first time going to factory, shoe factory.
You worked in a shoe factory.
They call grape shoes. Grape shoes, the steel factory.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. When they doing in grape shoes, in automatically I see how it's going. I like open. I understand everything for shoes.
Yes.
I open business. Open business, I working on a shoe factory, quit. I go to University Waterloo.
Yes.
For cleanup, for custodian.
Custodian. To help in the university,
yes.
For the cleaning up.
For cleanup. And for like that, I go in daytime, I going on a shoe repair store. I live there, shoe repair store.
You worked in the shoe repair store,
yeah,
during the day.
Day.
And at night you were a custodian at the University,
yeah, like
of Waterloo.
Yes.
So that was a lot of work. A
lot of work because spent money because I have house, I sell there, that money is very small.
You sold the house in Prilep?
So Prilep, very small. Mm-hmm. And for like that, my children it go up, we're going to school,
yes,
doing to school, and for like that. That,
yes,
time mortgage is very high, 14%.
Yes.
Not same here for today, 3%.
Right, and that was 1980.
No, 1975, 1980.
Yes,
yeah,
at that time, yeah, it was very high.
Very high,
mortgages.
Yeah.
And your wife, when you got married
yes,
in Prilep,
yes,
what date did you get married? What?
1953.
You got married in 1953.
Yes.
And when your wife came here and you were here working in the shoe store in the day repairing,
yes,
shoes,
daytime, yes,
and at night also night, working a second job, uh-huh, at the university,
and
your wife, what was she doing in
Canada?
She
doing in the Waterloo speeding, they to call for carpet.
She was working
in a carpet store and he doing that.
She was making carpeting, or
carpeting.
It was a store?
Carpeting.
Yes.
And that time, and after when moving to here in Toronto, that plastic stuff, I don't know, company. How
so she worked in a plastic factory?
Plastic factory.
Yes, it made plastics.
Or anyway, they working, and she working, and me working like that.
How long did you stay in Kitchener?
Kitchener, I stayed about, I think so,
for 15 years?
No, 7-8 years, like that.
Okay, you stayed in Kitchener for quite a while.
Yeah, yes.
Did you have your own store in Kitchener? Your own? You managed to open your own
shoe store in Kitchener?
Yes, shoe store. Tell us about that.
Okay, I opened a store in 1977.
Your first store in
first
Kitchener.
First store in Kitchener, 1977.
Mm-hmm.
And first time they coming, Croatian people, they like it, shoes. I know shoes that opanki, we call it dancing shoes. I don't know model, what kind style.
So you and had the
Croatian dancers
dancing, asking you,
yes,
to make the dancing shoes.
Yes, and
yes,
they bring me old, very old shoes and what style.
Yes.
They call Šestinski, and I starting from him.
So and at the beginning, did you, was your store to repair shoes, any kind of modern shoes?
Any kind shoes for repairing.
Yes.
And plus doing dancing shoes. Plus doing dancing shoes.
Yes, can you show us the kind of dancing shoes that you made?
I have dancing shoes that are different. This is Macedonian shoes.
Yes.
And if you like, give me, yeah, another shoes, the,
yes,
dancing first one.
So you made
Croatian.
They were the first ones were Croatian.
That's Macedonian shoes.
Uh-huh.
Another one, another more, okay.
Uh-huh. And tell us about what they're made of in the meantime. What are the the dancing shoes made of?
This leather, very nice leather, quality leather.
Yes.
And you have here in Toronto, in Canada.
Yes.
They have all leather. They coming now. How I buy that Mexico, very mm-hmm. good leather from Mexico, from many different countries.
Yes.
They bring here, and I buy the leather. They have lots of.
And then from the leather,
yes.
do you start from a piece of leather?
Yes.
All from scratch. You start making it.
Yes, they cutting. You know, first time measurement.
Yes.
How the patron they call? That's Croatian. Okay. That's exactly so Croatian.
Those were your very first type of shoes
first
that type you made.
Of shoes, yes.
Okay.
That's Croatian. For many color they have.
They need different colors.
Many
yes.
color.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and this. After these shoes, they cut coming Macedonian people.
Yes.
They like Macedonian dancing shoes.
Yes.
After they call Serbian shoes.
Yes.
I have Serbian that's ready there and things. So that's Serbian shoes.
Uh-huh.
I doing Polski,
Polish?
Ukrainian.
Ukrainian?
Yeah. And all shoes. Because in my country, doing just the Macedonian.
Yes.
They don't doing Croatian.
So how did you learn to do all the other
I'm
ones?
Learning, I take one pair of shoes, take out everything. We see what kind leather, what kind style they doing.
So
exactly.
you actually had to learn by yourself how to make the new styles.
That. And for like that in Canada, I am in, Edinstveni, how
you're,
they call
you're
it.
You're the only that one
only
who makes
one
made custom
yes,
ethnic
shoes.
Dancing shoes.
Or for any country,
any
European.
Country, any European
any
country.
That's for Macedonian patron, uh-huh. or how they call it.
This is
patron,
the pattern, yes.
Yeah, Macedonian, we cutting by clicker.
Yes.
Cutting dots and made all this. Again, doing here something,
yes.
Horse. For doing thread round.
Right.
If that's coming to this way.
That becomes a Macedonian dancing
like
shoe like that.
Yes.
And how long does it take you to make one pair of shoes from scratch, from the leather pattern?
That's when starting by hand, cutting leather.
Yes.
And doing myself everything, sewing by thread here and here in the back.
Yes.
Or how they call, I show to you here.
Yes.
Because here is sewing here by thread and sewing here by thread.
So is that by hand or by machine?
By hand.
By hand?
By hand.
All by hand?
No machine. Not
wow.
Can doing by machine from here to there.
Yes.
And supposed to be very strong. Supposed to be thread. Thread is very strong.
The thread
much,
is strong.
Much stronger than this. That's
even stronger
strong.
Than the leather. Yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And doing after this... doing nice.
Right.
First, how they call, very good quality I doing myself. Very good. Everybody dancing, people who
yes.
doing, buy from me. Or, you know, some people they bring from another country.
Yes.
I told to you that before, mm-hmm. I don't doing in Macedonian like that shoes, or like
yes.
that, or different like that shoes.
Yeah, show us the little ones for the kids.
For kids, yeah. You see, that's...
Those are little
Serbian,
children.
Serbian
They're,
children,
uh-huh.
yes.
Okay.
Serbian. And I doing myself here because I find some leather, nice leather for decoration.
It's beautiful.
Always here, any country, costume for kids, they very nice doing
nice costume,
nice costume,
mm-hmm.
and supposed to be and shoes supposed to be nice
matching.
Yes,
yes
for
that's
dancing
right.
for like that. That's very good. Sent to Croatian, they doing very nice Costa.
So you opened your first store in shop in,
yes,
in Kitchener,
yes.
And you stayed there for a few years. Mm-hmm. You started
yes.
a business there. People started
they
to
started,
know you.
Yes.
Yes. And then you came to Toronto.
Yes.
Why was that? Why did you move from Kitchener?
I moved because my kids is going to university.
Yes.
Živce coming to university in Toronto. And Lydia sent too, you know, that, or like that.
Mm-hmm. What year
important.
Did you move to Toronto?
I think so, 83, 85, like that.
Yes.
I remember, or
mm-hmm.
like that.
Around, in the
yes,
80s.
88, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And starting here, in business open again here. And that time I opened business, and shoe repair,
yes.
I doing, and doing same for cleaning stuff. I open, I go to Mount Sinai Hospital.
Oh, so you continued your evening cleaning
yeah.
job and at Mount Sinai
Mount
Hospital,
Sinai Hospital,
and during the day you were working in
because,
your business.
Yeah, because I that time very nice doing myself.
Yes.
Cleaning, and automatically university sent me to Mount Sinai Hospital.
Yes.
And they take me
right away. Oh, from Kitchener, the university.
Kitchener, university.
Of Waterloo.
Never
recommended.
Never stop. Never.
You to continue in Mount Sinai. Okay.
Sinai.
And what was your store called? What was the name of your store?
First time in Kitchener.
Yes.
I forgot to tell to you. KW Skopje.
Okay.
First time. After they doesn't understand people, KW Skopje, what is this Skopje? That no speak Skopje.
Nobody understood what it is.
Skopje, nothing. And after they tell me, okay, doing some another, how they doing Dusan. Same to English, Dusan doesn't reading. Dusan,
yes.
Dutan,
yeah.
And somebody tell me, one engineer, he tell me, why not tell Dusan, the Shan,
uh-huh.
Shan, and starting for Shan, I made name Shan.
So your shop was called Shan Shoes.
Shan Shoes.
Yeah, that was in Toronto. Where was it in Toronto, the Shan
Toronto,
Shoes shop?
Toronto, first time in Toronto, I moved to Scarborough, or after I opened business in Toronto, SM to Scarborough in the plaza. They call,
what were the
Birchmount,
two streets?
Birchmount
Plaza?
Birchmount Plaza.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You were in the Birchmount Plaza.
Yeah.
Yes. And when you started to work in your store,
yeah.
You said you worked all day in your store.
And all day in the store, and after going to Mount Sinai Hospital, or that time going from 2 o'clock afternoon
yes.
to night, 2 o'clock or like that, or 10
mm-hmm.
o'clock, like that. I know afternoon I doing, before my wife is in the store.
And your wife was in the store. Did she help you in the store, your wife?
Sam, she helped me, and today she know everything for dancing shoes, very much helped me.
So she worked with you on how
yes,
to make them?
Yes, all the time.
Yes?
That her job is here. This doing, this doing.
Okay.
I met patron, I give to her, and she put in the...
The decoration.
Just myself I doing... By nails.
Nails.
Couple nails for this.
Yes.
And she's sewing.
So she's finishing up.
Yeah.
Yes.
Finishing, yeah.
So how long do you still have your shop or is it?
I have a shop. Now I finish a shop about maybe 4 or 5 years. 4 or 5 years I finish shop.
Mm-hmm.
And I now I doing at home in the garage.
So you retired from your store?
Yes.
And you're still working at home?
Yes. Yes. Still working because there is not
anybody?
Too much to do. Spend too much for shoes, for dancing shoes, spend too much time.
Yes.
For no half for repairing shoes.
I wanted to ask you, when you worked in your store,
yes,
did you have any younger people who wanted to come and,
no,
and learn the no trade?
No. No, my wife just started learning, and some for shoe repair, some I give to some people, another store.
Yes.
Who doing shoe repair, mm-hmm, and I bring here. Same to people who doing for cleanup,
mm-hmm,
for shirt, for like that. Bring some another store and bring here, mm-hmm, to me.
Right.
You know,
why?
Too much shoe repair. I have lots of shoe repair.
But you give it to somebody else.
Somebody else.
Because it's a lot of... yeah. Are they to be repaired shoes like this or different or normal shoes?
Normal shoes.
Just normal shoes.
Normal.
But you don't do that anymore.
No.
You just anymore concentrate
just
on the ethnic...
Just the dancing shoes.
Dancing shoes.
Just the dancing
shoes. And when you said that you buy a leather piece,
yes,
how much is a piece of leather?
Depending. 120, mm-hmm, 50... $200,
mm-hmm,
depending how big that leather.
Yes.
How big.
And then when you make shoes, how much do you sell the shoes for?
Shoes I sell about three different style, because
yes,
three different, not style,
sizes?
Different sizes.
Sizes, yes.
That's different, that different, that's much different, another shoes.
Yes.
Because many people, they tell me, if call me, hello, for my son, how much that on pair shoes? For your son, how old? Oh, 18 years. Uh-huh. Not children. They,
so he needs big
tell
shoes.
Me, for my kids.
Yes.
You know, for my kids. Okay, for your kids, your son, 18 years, or not for me kids. That's
a man's size.
Man's
that's
size,
right,
you know.
Yes.
Many mistakes.
So how much does one pair, man's size shoe cost?
Men's size shoes today cost about $100.
$100.
Yeah.
And how about...
I tell to you, that's English about 14 size English.
Yes.
If smaller... Cost 60,
mm-hmm,
50, like that. Starting from 50, like that.
Like that
for 50.
50, yes.
50, 60, 80, and mm-hmm 100.
Right. So how long does it take you to make one pair of shoes?
One pair process like that, shoes, take 3 hours minimum, just myself.
Yes.
I know long time I doing everything. Or not before, depending sizes.
Right.
I'm doing 2 hours or 3 hours, depending size.
Yes.
Or cost, leather seem to cost about $35.
The leather?
Leather.
Just the leather
just
costs
leather,
about $35.
And my hours, 3 hours for $10, $30. And nobody coming to me help me for $10. Nobody coming. Because if I pay $20 for hours,
yes,
that costs just for job $60-$70.
Mm-hmm.
Where is material?
Yes.
You know,
how much does it cost? You said you mentioned one big piece costs about $200.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, depending.
How many shoes can you make from one piece?
Not
usually
just for that leather. Or
no.
That, how they call it? That this leather is different.
Yes.
This leather is different. So it's different.
Yes.
That cost about 200. This is cost maybe 200 another leather.
Yes.
And depending how many, mm-hmm, sizes you cutting leather.
Right. Know.
how many sizes, you see?
Yes.
One size, that very small size, 35, 36.
Yes.
That's sizes. Cost about $30-$35 minimum for one pair.
Just to make pair of shoes.
Yes.
Yeah, without your work.
Before I have some lady I give to at home for doing just this one sewing crown.
She sewed, yes?
Yeah. I pay $10 for pair. I pay $10. Mm-hmm. They doing before. Or she better going some job.
Yes.
And take $15-$20.
Mm-hmm.
Do not pay for that my job. For like that I have before some lady
help.
Who help me.
Yes.
And they going, they take postman, lady or postman.
Postwoman, yeah.
Yeah, woman. And postwoman, they take, now they take $20 for hours.
Yes. So young people did not come to learn.
No coming.
And you think it's because?
Yes. And same too, I like bring some guy, because if I die, then who doing for dancing shoes?
Yes.
All this just bring from there.
Yes.
I from government, I asked for, give me some guy, helper, from there,
yes.
I bring, they tell me no money for extra money,
yes.
For pay to him.
Yes.
For
yes.
Like that, they mm-hmm. don't give me bring here.
Mm-hmm.
That Zanaet, how they call
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it's Izumira. A special trade, an old trade that is,
trade
that is slowly
going,
disappearing.
Same to tailor, no half tailor.
Why? Yes.
Because no. The group
yes,
that are together. No.
Yes, the factories make a lot of shoes
yeah.
and clothing a lot cheaper. Is
I
that right?
Ask,
yeah.
I ask doing doing China, or I have five model.
Yes.
For this model, they tell me how many pair.
Yes.
Okay, give me maybe 500. No, 5,000.
So you
pair.
In
how
order,
I pay one model 5,000,
yes.
another 5,000,
yes.
you'll be billionaire.
Yes.
You
so know. In China, they said they will produce them, but en masse, at least 5,000 pairs, not just
not
a few.
Yeah. For like that, I can't do nothing to do. Not just one Macedonian, 5,000. Where sell?
Mm-hmm.
Supposed to be stayed 10 years. No.
Yes.
No.
Right.
You know, can doing in my because China he like made machine for sewing this
yes.
round.
Yes.
That machine cost much money.
That machine costs a lot of money.
Lots
that's
of
right.
money, sure. That's
yes.
No good. For that, but this is different machine.
Mm-hmm. Do you know anybody that is interested?
Nobody. I tell to. I'm in the radio, in
yes.
the news advertising.
Yes.
I tell who like it coming for
mm-hmm.
learning. Nobody tell.
Yeah. And in the meantime, you're very well known for your workmanship, and there have been many articles about you, about your good work,
yes.
great work.
Yes.
And I know that in Macedonia there was. There was an article about you working in Canada as a person in the diaspora making the open sea. How about in Macedonia? Do you think there are some people who are making?
They have some old people.
Yes.
A couple. I know that's a couple people who are doing private in the at home.
Yes.
No, in the business, they take. From another company, very hard for
mm-hmm. Yes.
Find Macedonian no, just a Kumanovo. They Kumanovo. They have some guy who doing or old people, and no quality for me. No quality.
So in Macedonia there are some people who are still making them.
Very few. very small.
Not many.
No, not many. Uh-huh. And sent to, if going to Macedonian, buy just Macedonia.
Yes.
It look like that.
Yes.
No. But to be go to Hrvatska.
Do you think in Croatia there are people making those or not too
Croatian,
many?
Croatia, not too many.
Again, the same.
Them they tell me that they're not there.
Even in Croatia, it's difficult to find.
I was Dubrovnik. Mm-hmm. I was Dubrovnik, and they tell me, no more people who doing that.
Yeah, Čičko Dušan. Сега да зборниме малце по наше, по македонски.
Да,
вие цело време работевте во Канада тешко и во продавницата од правевте опинци
да.
Цело време за играчите, децата што
да.
Играат во македонската играорна, во српската, во хрватската, дури во полските и така натака. А цело време додека бевте во Канада, работевте
да.
и во продавницата, и дури и навечер работевте.
Да.
А кажете ни малце за приватниот културен живот. Дали ко бевте во, на пример, во Торонто, бевте во некоја црква, учествувавте во која црква одевте или
во нашата црква овде кај Свети Климент? Уште одам, ако да. Е чекс близко, само во големава црква најмногу тогаш одам. А, иначе, контактирам со овие играорците и да, по некој купуваат,
да.
Само веројатно црквите има едно право, како да кажам, да донеса за групите нивни,
да.
Не плаќа царин.
Да.
И македонците не сме многу кажуваа дека нешто кажува, него вела дека само хрватите се 1000 играорци во годината.
Имат
1000 играорци само, не.
The Croatians have 1000.
А
фолк десет во Торонто.
Србите во Торонто.
In Toronto. Да. Yes.
Србите има преку 1000.
And the Serbians have more than 1000.
More than 1000.
That's a lot of shoes.
Да. Али сите то преку црквите носат, така да црквите и ослободува од такс.
So they така, bring the shoes from there?
Shoes from there.
Oh, they bring the shoes from there.
Or, и таму не може да најда, и зато различни носат.
Mm-hmm.
Различни носат. Имам видено дека и тие со патики негде играт.
Да. So it's difficult to find shoes, but do they come to you in order?
They have.
Ти ордираат тебе.
Ордираат мене и ордираат преку интернет.
И преку интернет се продава.
Сайт.
Ти имаш сайт.
Имам сайт и во него се пишува и српски и македонски и хрватски.
И имате нарачка од интернет?
Да,
да, и така интернет. Продавате?
И така ги продавам.
Од дома си работите?
Зато сега велам дека ова ми е регистрирано
да.
Само за импорт, да испрејчам.
Само да испрејчеш?
Да испрејчам, да.
Да.
А, многу реклами прам нарачито, може имате видено, на пикниците. Чим ни јават дека има пикник таму, јас одам изложувам сите врсти опинци.
Да.
Без разлика како пикник е и што е.
Да.
И тогаш луѓето гледа и си зема телефон
да.
Да, и сето информешен.
И сето информешен.
Да, да.
Yeah.
Оти има доста пикници наши. Само на македонскиот ние на две години изнесов. Така да ме знаат, сите ме знаат.
Сите ве знаат дека правите опинци.
Сите ме знаат.
Да. Чичко Душан, имате прекрасен занает. Со вашиот занает ја ширите македонската култура, затоа што опинците се еден дел од нашите играорни носи, што се многу важни и многу типично македонски, ни ги покажавте.
Нашата вера.
Овие, така се типично македонски. И you have done an amazing job at keeping the Macedonian ethnic and cultural dancers with the proper shoes, yeah. And you're helping to do that with other ethnic groups as well. But most definitely, it's a wonderful trade, and we hope that there will be some interest in the newer generation, perhaps to learn how to do it and yeah. And continue to make these important items for the Macedonian dancers, so they can continue to dance and spread the Macedonian culture.
Pa, even me. Kažem, sakat I Srbite da imam intervju, bekad mnogo gi pomagam.
Yes.
Ti sam od kaj mi ne sam atopinci, mnogo gi pomagam.
Mnogo ste popularen.
Popularen.
So, site drugi, da, site drugite. Na, nacionalni
grupi. A isto grupi. Hrvatite imam pohvali, za blagodarne, kako da rečem, pisma.
Vi ima dadeno pisma, thank you letters. Aha. Wonderful.
Imam... Една година дојдоја од шо го кажуваја во таун центар Скарборо. Скарборо
да.
И таму го изложуваја сите зедоа разни опинци од кај мене
да.
И да изложат да видат дека се пратов дека во Канада.
Да.
Многу луѓе не веруваат дека се пратови опинци во Канада, не верува, не знам.
Да, ама кога ќе ви видат, ќе видат дека на вистинска.
Да, да.
Чичко Душан, што сакате да му кажете на младите генерации што ќе го гледат ова видео?
Абе, многу убо е младите стварно да настојуваат да се држат традицијата, да се мешат децата со оние наши деца, што да не одат, така речено, по други нации, друго нешто да научат. Ова е многу убо историско, дека Македонија си има своја врста опинци, кои не, сакам да речам, од Македонија ги зема бугарите, јас прам бугарски, а да. Тие се истите опинци овие.
Истите наши македонски.
Истите македонски. Да. Бугарите... Србите ги зема
од нас,
од нас истите македонски mm-hmm. за шопски. Тие ги има играорни шопски yeah. игри.
Da.
И затоа велам дека македонските се најпопуларни оти за бугарите и за шопците,
da.
Србите и македонците наши.
So the Macedonian da. Shoes are very popular and used by both the Bulgarians and the da. Шопски Сербијанци.
А хрватските ги зема како мукасенки. Оти во времето некогаш некоја зела од Охрид и вели дека ја сакам охридски. Какви охридски? Коми носи модел стар ова. А тие се хрватски, реков, не знам.
Да. Да.
А стварно таа не знае, оти од Охрид и зела, мисли дека охридски е. Да. Тие се охридски. Ја.
Добро.
Добро е, да, добро е да се бидат децата сите, да се биде во една компанија, во едно, што се вели, добро заедничко друштво, со еден јазик, со исто, со една живечка. И добро да се имат... бракове, еве, многу кажува дека децата чи миграат, се зацакуваат, се има бракови, се сродуваат
да.
Со, заедно.
Yes, it's a way to keep the наци, culture going.
Сите нации си сакат така, да србите си сакат со србиве да се игра. И затоа имаме, најмногу деца има овдека во Торонто, али не гледајат само Торонто, па Ниегара, па Хамилтон, па... Каде не, нис ова, Чикаго, од сегде испречам се ордени.
Одлично, Чичко Душан, фала ви многу за ова интервју и нашите гледачи ќе научат дека вие сте човекот што ги прави опинците од првин до последно и дека го правите тоа со љубов и со душа.
Јас велам дека... Единиот опинчар што сум јас, што прам од сите врсти опинци.
Thank
сите
you.
Сите врсти.
You're the only one that makes different types of dancing shoes and you do it all by yourself, with your wife's help sometimes.
Не може да направи Србин хрватски опинци во Србија. Ne možete prodaj.
Dobro, thank you.
Dobro.
Hvala mnogo, Čičko, Dušan, i mnogo ti blagodarime za ovaj intervju.